even be here. I fucked myself up on Christmas playing basketball with a short-ass rim. I was dunking on niggas for the first time in my life. Fell down into a brick wall. My arms sound like Transformers. I was like, this is not gonna be good. Got to the doctor, they said a nigga had a mild concussion, fractured my wrist, fractured my elbow, and tore two tendons. I was like, okay, I got a show in Vegas. I can't miss this shit. My doctor, yes, my blessed doctor gave me a prescription for Tramadol and Percocet. I don't know if it's my Vegas spirit or the fact that I'm on both of them. I'm gonna let this motherfucker loose tonight. This is Vegas. If you know anything about Tramadol and Percocet, together they make a motherfucker feel like a superhero. It took away shit that wasn't even already hurting and stopped hurting. Think about Tramadol, it make you forget you got an arm at all. So if I break my arm tonight, just leave it on the ground. We gonna keep this show rolling. Now, how many of y'all are actually from Vegas? Make some noise. How many people visiting Vegas? Make some noise. Yes. Can we give it up for this wonderful theater? I have never in my life performed in a place more beautiful than this one right here. Shout out to the Park Theater. I started in Boston, now I'm here. 20 years ago, first time I performed in Vegas, he told me I was performing in Vegas and my name was on the marquee. We stayed in Vegas and performed in Reno. The marquee was a banner with my name spelled wrong. So I'm glad to be here. Vegas is a wonderful place. There's no place like it. You can win at the MGM. Remember I told you. I played slots all night because my arm was hurting. I don't know if it's because a nigga wasn't trying to win. Every ticket I put in fucking spit out money. Might have been this Percocet and Tramadol. But at 3 in the morning, I found out I had been shoving my money in a vending machine for about 30 minutes. Every time I put 100 in, they gave me 100 back. I thought I was doubling up on that bitch. Fucked up. Vegas always got surprises for you. I left the East Coast to come here. I was talking shit all the way through the airport. Thought I was coming somewhere warm. It was 49 where I left from. It was 43 in this bitch. This is the wrong Vegas. This is not the Vegas. How you gonna have a frozen ass desert? That don't even make sense to go there. If you're visiting Vegas, be careful. Stay your ass on the strip. You can get killed on any street with an alphabet ladder. Watch yourself. On A3G, you better ask Siri. Siri, am I supposed to be here? Get your ass out the letter streets. Vegas is a great place. You can win here at the MGM. Everywhere in Vegas got buffets. Buffets, oh, I love to see fat people in buffets. You'll think they really want some shit. They trying to get as much shit on one plate as they possibly can. They got pie next to cookies, cookies next to pineapples. They got chicken on the top, macaroni and cheese on the side. I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to be here. We started a new year. How many people are excited about 2017? So glad to get rid of fucking 2016. I didn't give a fuck what year was after. The Kill Prince left me as the only perm in America. I'm just glad. Whole motherfucking world is changing. We can't worry about the change. We gotta fight with the change. Some shit is gonna change. You didn't expect. Trump is finna be the president. Look at the white people playing it off like they don't know how it happened. I knew that shit was going down when CNN was showing the pictures of white people in line. 6 hours they was in line. They did not look mad at all. All of them looked like they had a secret. the most fun was what happened to CNN. CNN ain't never been that wrong in their life. They already had the election results before the election started. They had beautiful screens with numbers up. Every little neighborhood was broken down. They were showing you the shit. Look, there's no way that Trump can win this. Unless he win here, 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 and here. They came back from commercial, them motherfuckers were sweating and shit. Look at the numbers again. Bring the numbers up. Now the black people, and they killed all the niggas. What? The Hispanics ain't coming out. What Hispanics? None of them. Fucked up. I gotta say this shit in the last few days that it can be said. Barack Obama did a great motherfucking job while he was president. Trump coming in like, he don't give a fuck about the rules. You let me in, goddammit. He didn't wait till he started. He started when he started. I'm over the name, this cabinet is Hitler, Satan, Darth Vader. He can't do this, can he? Somebody gotta give Obama some credit. Let me say, as a black person, he made niggas proud, and that's some hard shit to do. He did us good. He didn't get in no scandals. He just showed up with them clean-ass suits, walking from country to country, making America look good. And Michelle Obama was right with him every step of the way, showing the world what a real black stallion looked like in real life. First lady, motherfuckers. Everybody did a good job. Sasha and Malia did a good job. They didn't get in no scandals, didn't get kicked out of school, showed up pregnant, none of that. Eat they up, nappy-headed ass dog did a good job. He didn't have a shit in the front yard of the White House on TMZ, none of that. They made Obama go through hoops to be president. They made that nigga stop playing basketball, quit his church, couldn't have a phone, and then can't talk without permission. Trump came in and had a victory tour in this bitch. We gotta learn, sometimes change ain't bad. We can't change everything, we can only change ourselves, goddammit. It don't matter who the president is, we got to get through it. We had our first black president, now we finna have our first flaming hot Cheeto president. The little orange boys and girls know they can do it too. And he did it with that hair, so you can do it with any hair. I knew Trump had a chance because the motherfucker was excited. And at some point, Americans just want some motherfucking excitement. I knew he had a chance because every morning he would scare me and my breakfast blunt. It's crazy to have a motherfucker threaten to blow your high every morning. I'm not like y'all, I'm short. I don't put my TV way up on the motherfucking wall. I put that motherfucker halfway by the wall so I can look at people eye to eye on TV. You're damned if I'm gonna feel short in my own goddamn house. Every day, I would say Trump can't say no more shit that's gonna surprise me. Every morning his shit got crazy and crazy. First he said he's gonna build a wall between us and Mexico. Then he said he was gonna make Mexicans pay for it. What the fuck? What kind of Mexicans does he know? He must not know no essays or Latin. Do shit. Then why the fuck would we waste our taxpayer money making a motherfucking wall? And the Mexican people have proven to us that they are excellent at building tunnels on your ass. Yes, they broke out El Chapo while they was looking at it. They were going to sail with him when he disappeared. Red North Star. They showed that tunnel as big as this goddamn stage. Had linoleum, granite, hardwood floors, water fountains, water machines. They had them on a golf cart. They took them to a little pool room. It was air conditioned. No more shit. He said, we're gonna crack down on illegal immigration. Wait a motherfucking minute. Your wife ain't even from here, motherfucker. What the fuck is she talking about immigration? That bitch is from Camp Snatterstein. Look at that bitch pronounced just like it's spelled. Camp Snatterstein. After he said that, I said, okay, I'm sure this motherfucker ain't got no more shit. Then one morning, we all woke up and heard some shit we had never heard on the news before. We woke up to grab him by the pussy. You checking your TV at the CNN? Grab him by the pussy. Even gangster niggas were surprised. What? Why did you do that at? That's what I'm saying. We've been shaking bitches' hands and shit. Point is, the world is motherfucking changing. You just gotta accept motherfucking change. I fired everybody who bought clothes for me because they kept bringing me my size. That wasn't my motherfucking size. I said, I'm going out by my own shit. I found out you can't help but buy skinny jeans. They don't sell regular ass jeans. They just skinny and skinnier. I bought myself a sweatsuit. That motherfucker was so tight when I got home. I fell asleep while I was in it. You know how tight your shit gotta be for you to feel comfortable going to sleep in it? It felt like Jesus was giving a nigga a warm hug.
Right in the front yard, don't you even think about coming in here.
this front yard before we both get shot. Samuel L. Jackson is selling the shit out them Capital One commercials. That nigga be cleaner than the Board of Health. You just have to turn down your TV. What's in your wallet? Goddamn, Sam, I forgot to do it. Public service announcement, you know the cold weather is here. I don't want none of y'all to catch the flu. Don't catch it. I personally can't catch it. They give you a flu shot every time you go to jail. I legally can't catch the flu. Till 2026 or something like that. I can't catch nothing. Tuberculosis, mesothelioma. None of us know what the fuck mesothelioma is. All of us think we just might have it. Are you feeling fatigued? Yeah, motherfucker, I'm in bed. You might have mesothelioma. All for a check.
Yeah.
I was drinking that miso soup back there. Don't catch the flu. The flu was not created by God. The devil created the flu. You can tell because the flu wants you to do something your body can't even do. The flu wants you to be in two places at the same time. Nothing else does that. You catch the flu, you run right to the bathroom, you go right past the toilet, I don't need you yet. You go right to the sink, get the cold water, splash it on yourself. Start throwing up. The flu is the only time you are excited about throwing up. Because you keep thinking you throwing the sickness up. You roar! That's it right there. Oh, she feel like, roar! One more bit of flu. And right when you get your sink together, your lower intestine says, guess what, motherfucker? It's my turn too. Motherfucker, I am throwing up. I cannot throw up in shit. Like a baseball player in between first and second base. You... And the flu shit is nothing like your regular shit. Your asshole generally knows to wait on your belt. You regular shit, you got time to take your shit off, have a seat, then it knows it's time to shit. Flu just puts that shit in fast forward. As soon as you get your pants. Fucked up. They gotta fix something with this motherfucking flu. Now, anybody will give you the flu vaccine. But if you go to CVS, they will give you the flu vaccine without your permission. I was in line to CVS buying snacks and goodies and shit, Reese's cups, potato chips. This bitch just hit me out of nowhere. Ah! What the fuck? You stab me? That's your flu shot, but you got to tell me first. Made me so scared I ran out, forgot my keys. Ran back in to get my keys. This bitch hit a nigga again. A band-aid, bitch. This is the bad part. They just did the math on the flu vaccine. Turns out the flu vaccine is 27% effective. 27%? This nigga's in here with GEDs that know that's bad math. That's bad. Go to your local weed salesman. Let that motherfucker sell you a bag of 27% weed. You'd be mad enough to kill everybody that look like him. You look at your bag, it's broccoli, asparagus, Brussels sprouts. You gotta be happy with your life. Don't act like there ain't no motherfucking miracles out there. There are still miracles out there. Some of them may be small, but they are life-changing nonetheless. I'm gonna give you a perfect example. many men in here know that Viagra works his ass off? Make some noise. Look at these niggas. Trying to keep a secret and shit. Some of y'all broke your hands trying not to clap. You see who's been in the Admiral? Every man in here knows Viagra works. You either know because you needed that shit, or you know because you didn't need it. You just figured you'd see what it would do. Every man in here knows most shit does not work. Viagra is not one of them things. That one don't work too good. They make your dick hard and give you a headache at the same time. You delivering pleasure and feeling pain. You just, Viagra works. You swallow it and go right to your dick, no delay. You be standing there wondering, I wonder, is it even gonna get big enough for me to even notice? Viagra make your dick so big you don't even wanna touch it. It look like another nigga's dick. You just staring at it.
I'm way up, I feel blessed. Way up, I feel blessed.
Most shit don't work. Viagra work too motherfucking good. Viagra make you fuck till you don't wanna fuck anymore. As a man, we never experienced that shit. You fuck her till you get sad about it. Like, why am I doing this? She gotta be up at 3 in the morning. I'm gonna fuck her hair. She gonna call at 7 in the morning. I'm gonna bang her all up against this. Viagra ain't shit. Viagra make your dick forget who's in charge. As a man, you used to tell your dick one thing and it immediately does it. Viagra make your dick ignore you for the first time in life. I specifically said to my dick, okay, that's about enough now. Go on and wrap it up. My dick knows when I say that means we have done our job. It is time for the dismount. Viagra made my dick ignore me. I was like, that's about enough. Wrap it up. My dick said, nope. Push it. Some of you men don't give that Viagra credit. You know you needed that shit. You know you prayed for the first time with your dick in your hand. Dear Lord, please. You raised Lazarus from the dead, Jesus. Just lay your mighty hands upon me. Now, I didn't bring up Viagra because of men. Where's the ladies at this evening? Make some noise. Ladies, where are y'all at? I come to bring y'all some great news. This year, for the first time ever, they're gonna start selling female Viagra. Huh? I got the older women's attention. They were trying to look up for the first time in 20 years. What did that nigga say? That's right, ladies. Female Viagra. And they say even if you're 62, it'll bring you back to when you was at your hottest. I got old vagina's attention now. I'm gonna bring it back, Jesus. You know I'll bring it back. That's gonna bring old women back into the game. There's only two types of classic pussy. Old classic pussy and new classic pussy. Old classic is a classic for a reason. She don't want to come no whole bunch of times. She got shit to do. Shit in the crock pot. She just want to come one time, but she want to come hard as hell. Like slavery prohibition hard. She like, boo! One time, but it ain't gonna be easy. You gonna have to work for that one time. She can't move one of her hips and one of her knees. You gonna have to move your body. You got to get up in there while she in the chair. When she get there, you gonna know and she gonna start saying shit that don't even exist. Get me a rotary phone. Hurry up, they're coming. And she, boo! That's the end of that. You gone about your life. These young bitches done took it to another level. Man, if you over 40, you got one of these 25, 26-year-olds, make sure your insurance is right before you go in there. These bitches ain't made like regular women. These is robots. These bitches want to come 19 times in a row. As a man, we think as soon as you done it, that's the end of it. Young bitches want all the positions. Ah, 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 ah. God damn, greedy bitch. What's your sleep number, bitch? How many times do you have to come for you take your ass to sleep? Young girl's ready. That's why, man, we gotta be on our game. Social media is real. They will tell all your friends you can't fuck. You gotta be body. Some of you women need to understand what... Thank you, nice lady. All right, Satan gave us a little break. Just want to bring in the new Park Theater, right? Everything was fine till Cat Williams got there. Appreciate y'all. What I was saying was, some of you women gotta be thankful. If that was a black woman, we would never have stopped. But that's a white woman making that noise. But not in Trump's America. Security scared to touch her. Who you with? Y'all got a Trump Tower in Vegas. That's the second White House. Thank you, nice lady. I appreciate that. Didn't want to focus on that when I was focusing on that. Okay. Some of you ladies are in a prime motherfucking position because you done found you a good man. And you don't give him enough credit, but some of you women are in here with a man with great dick. Yes. Don't give it away, ladies. You know these single bitches ain't shit. They don't look like vultures and shit. Gave away your great dick secret. Notice I didn't say big dick, I said great dick. I don't know sizes, I just know when you get it right. Great dick. Fellas, some of y'all looking at me confused, not really sure if you got good dick or great dick. This is how you tell. You got great dick if you can let her see your dick before it gets hard. Or you can walk right up on the bed just... Water, we'll get this started. You got regular dick, you gotta hide all around the bedroom till your dick get right. You behind the TV and shit, all up in the plants with behind the curtain. But every man in here will tell you great dick don't mean shit till you find yourself a woman with great pussy. Huh? Vegas got great pussy. And you Vegas women, you ain't got to compete with the hoes no more. These Vegas hoes is looking raggedy as shit. Yikes.
Yikes.
They're working hard, but they're looking like they're working hard. Some of you women in here got great pussy. I know. As a man, great dick don't mean shit till you find that one great pussy. As a man, we don't know what great pussy look like. You don't know about it until you get up in there. Something happens when you put great dick and great pussy together. One thing for certain, it does not make you taller. I know that for a fact. I don't have that shit at all. But it makes your bones strong. Don't put a great great dick with some great pussy, make your bones strong. You walk away from it feeling different. You just feel it. That's great pussy. Great pussy got power in it. Great pussy will make a man snitch on himself. As a man, you ain't never snitched in your life. Great pussy make you say some shit you honest to God did not mean to say out loud. You know I got two phones, right?
I got two phones.
One is for my grandmother. She ain't up here. That's great pussy. But now everybody ain't got great dick and great pussy. There's a group in here that nobody ever talks about. We gonna air your ass out tonight. Where's all the bitches with awful pussy? Make some noise. Oh no, it's 6,000 of us in here. That means I'm talking to 36 of you dirty trifling bitches. You know your vagina smell like the inside of a trash can. Look at them looking at me mean and shit. Ought to be ashamed of yourself. If something's wrong with your pussy, stop delivering it to motherfuckers. Tell us it's broken or some shit. As a man, our life is too hard for that shit. As a man, we think the vagina is the greatest thing God ever put on this planet. Period, period, period. 3 exclamation points, 4 emojis, and a period. We go down there, we are expecting to see the Garden of Eden. We get down there and see that haunted house you done threw together down there. I'm not going in there. She ain't even got a lap no more. She just got curtains hung up. They don't even match. Some of you women looking at me like I'm saying something fucked up. No. I don't mean that once in a blue moon medical shit. I don't mean you accidentally got the wrong drawers from Walmart that one time. Or a swimsuit you shouldn't have worn. Not that. I'm talking about you bitches who know your shit is fucked up. You gon' keep working till they find a cure. Don't tell me ain't no cure. If that shit is fucked up, you try to fix it. Dedicate your life. You should be in the feminine hygiene department mixing shit together that don't even go together. Working for a cure, Metamucil, Massengale, pineapple syrup, swirl it in your mouth, swallow it down, do 25 Kegel exercises, right in the frozen food department and freeze it off the top. Because I'm a real comedian and y'all are a real audience, that means tonight real shit is gonna happen. Real shit. That means, ladies, you know if your man got great dick, you know he finna give it to you. And fellas, I'm gonna let you know the new 2017 shit. This the new shit. You wanna take it to the next level. You know your woman. You know when she gonna come and that's finna be it. Hold off on some so you got something when she thinks it's over. Act like it's almost over. Get back in there like it's brand new. Take her to the next level. Y'all will not believe what happens once she thinks she's done. If you take her to the next done, the done, it is done. Take her. Whatever she ordinarily gives you, just take her to the next level. You won't surprise yourself. If she generally gives you a dolphin, or a porpoise, she do a little squirting out the hole and keep going till she give you a whale. Just go to the next level. If she generally give you a little chimpanzee, you fuck her all the way to gorilla. That's right. If she generally give you a chimpanzee, just some of these niggas get mad. How the fuck he know how you sound? You take that chimpanzee all the way to the gorilla. Just, don't stop till she. she get in the car, it was already cold out there, she will get in the car, it's gonna get warm, and her pussy just gonna start beatboxing in the car. She'll be judging your driving, look at him running all the red lights and shit. You gotta go to jail, but what is your pussy? But your ass got awful pussy. This is gonna be a terrible ride home for you. This is gonna be the coldest, quietest night you've ever experienced. You get in the car, that nigga's gonna drive all the way home without looking at you or the road. He's just gonna drive sideways. Finally, you gonna have enough. And you gonna say, Jerome, you need to watch Jerome. And Jerome is gonna say, bitch, you need to listen to Cat Williams. Himself, Mr. Mark Curry, make some noise for him. Also, give it up for Shalon and our wonderful openers. Thank y'all for our
Yeah. Y'all keep it going for one more time for Mr.